Hello and welcome to Shuttle Flash. Lin Dan has retired from international badminton. If not the greatest men's singles badminton player of all time, then he surely is the greatest men's singles player of the 21st century. The glories he achieved and the titles he won during his 20-year-long career is not even comparable to any other player, especially in the open era of badminton. So in this video, we will go through 10 things you probably didn't know about Lin Dan. But before that, if you are more interested in music montages and tributes, then please go and check out the second channel. An epic Lin Dan tribute video has been uploaded on the second channel. The link is down in the description box. Please give the video a like and a subscribe if you can. So here are the top 10 things you probably did not know about Lin Dan. Number 10. The first one is an easy one. It was fellow legend Peter Gade who gave the nickname Super Dan to Lin Dan. After Peter Gade lost to Lin Dan in the 2004 All England final, Peter Gade described Lin Dan as Super Dan in the post-match interview, and it was quickly picked up by various media houses. And since then, Lin Dan came to be known as Super Dan. Lin Dan also had another nickname earlier in his career, Lin Yi Lun, which translates into English as Lin First Rounder. In 2001, the International Badminton Federation introduced an experimental 7-point system which was eventually scrapped in 2002. Lin Dan failed to adjust to the 15-point system when it was brought back, and in the second half of 2002, he lost almost all of the tournaments in the first round. This is how he got the nickname Lin the First Rounder. Number 9. Until the End of the World. Lin Dan has many tattoos over his body, and each one of them signifies something. If you don't already know the meaning of his tattoos, there is a YouTube video in which the different tattoos are explained in detail. One of them is the phrase, "Until the End of the World," which is tattooed on his upper right arm. Until the End of the World is the name of the closing song of the famous Japanese anime series Slam Dunk, which Lin Dan found very inspiring. But did you know Lin Dan never listened to this song until 2012? Even though he had completed watching the whole series 10 years back, Lin Dan watched Slam Dunk again when he was on a flight from China to Germany to participate in the 2012 German Open. He always used to skip the closing song because he wanted to know what happens to the protagonist Sakuragi Hanamichi in the next episode. But during this flight, he listened to the full length of the song for the first time in his life and found it to be inspiring. Now, many of you might think Slam Dunk was Lin Dan's favorite anime during his young days. Nope, that's wrong. Lin Dan's favorite anime series was Doraemon. Number 8. His parents. Lin Dan also comes from a humble background just like Lee Chong Wei. When he was a child, Lin Dan's father was a truck driver and he later became a bus driver. And his mother worked as a salesperson in a pharmaceutical company. His mother worked extremely hard during his childhood days. She worked 3 shifts a day to keep the family afloat. Number 7. His retirement. Lin Dan announced the news of his retirement on July 4th, but did you know that he chose to make the announcement on Weibo exactly at 12 noon? He did so because he wanted it to represent the next chapter of his life. Since retirement, Lin Dan has made a seamless transition into the entertainment industry and has become a regular judge on a talent show. Number 6. Fitness. Until 2012, out of all the members in the Chinese national team, Lin Dan had the lowest body fat percentage. This was the period when Lin Dan was almost 30 years old, when almost all of his teammates were younger than him, like Chen Long was only 23 years old. Such was the extreme level of fitness that Lin Dan maintained during his heydays. During a training session, Lin Dan defeated Chen Long and all his younger teammates in a sprint race. They were not happy with the result and demanded a rematch from Lin Dan. Lin Dan went 5 more rounds against them and won every single one of them. However, he ended up with a cramp on his calf muscle and had to rest for 3 days. Number 5. Top numbers in statistics. Lin Dan has the best match winning percentage in a single calendar year. In 2014, Lin Dan played 38 matches and lost only 2 matches. This translates into a winning percentage of 95%, which is the highest by any men's singles player. Coming in at a close second with a percentage of 94.9% is also Lin Dan, which is his winning percentage from 2009. These numbers show how dominating Lin Dan really was when he was on the top of his game. Prior to 2017, only 5 players had a positive head-to-head record against Lin Dan, and to be honest, only 2 out of the 5 records have some significance in terms of head-to-head statistics. Number 4. Longest winning streak. In 2019, Kento Momota made headlines by winning 11 titles in a calendar year. Commentators also applauded Momota's winning streak of 28 matches. However, it is Lin Dan who actually holds the record of the longest match winning streak. Lin Dan had a winning streak of 30 matches in 2006, which is the highest in men's singles. He also repeated the same feat in 2012-2014, although there was a walkover match the second time he did it. Number 3. Appendicitis. In 1998, Lin Dan represented Bai Yi team and went to Chengdu to participate in a tournament. After a match, he was having a meal with Wu Yong, who was one of his teammates from the Bai Yi team. His teammate made a joke by saying, "You are the number one in badminton, but you cannot eat spicy food." Lin Dan, who was famous for being a hothead, refused to accept defeat and said to his teammate, "It's all about eating chilies, right? I will not lose to you in this as well." And immediately, Lin Dan started eating a lot of chilies, and this caused him a lot of pain in his stomach and resulted in acute appendicitis. He had to undergo emergency surgery for this. Even at this point, Lin Dan told his coach not to inform his parents to prevent them from worrying about him. In the end, his teammate Wu Yong's mother traveled 300 kilometers from their home to take care of Lin Dan at the hospital. Number 2. Armotech 700. If you play badminton and if you follow Lin Dan, then you definitely know what racket Lin Dan uses. He has used the Yonex Voltric LD Force, the Z Force 2, and when he was partnered with Lining, he used the Lining Woods N90. The racket which Lin Dan used to win his first Olympic gold medal at Beijing in 2008 was the Yonex Armotech 700. But do you know the reason why he used this racket? He started using this racket because this was the racket which Taufik Hidayat used while winning the gold medal at the 2004 Athens Olympic Games. Lin Dan always regarded Taufik very highly and was fixated with winning the Olympics after his disappointing exit in Athens. Lin Dan thought the racket which Taufik was using is the best racket in the world, so he started using this racket. There's another interesting story about this racket. When Lin Dan was preparing for the 2008 Olympics, he broke about one Armotech 700 racket every 3 days. Whenever his practice did not go well, he would be furious and he would break his racket. And the Armotech 700 he was using was a limited edition model, so all his teammates who were previously using this racket stopped using it so that they can lend their rackets to Lin Dan. Number 1. Number 46 Tattoo. This video is from 2012 and this video is from 2013. If you look carefully at the back of his neck, you will see a difference in his tattoo. Lin Dan has the number 46 tattooed at the back of his neck, but have you ever wondered what's the significance of this number? Is it because of Valentino Rossi? Just kidding. The number 46 tattoo on Lin Dan's neck represents the size of suit which he wears. Lin Dan does not want to become fat or oversized when he grows old. He wishes to keep wearing a size 46 throughout his life until the day he grows old. So as a reminder to himself, he had the number 46 tattooed on the back of his neck. That's pretty inspiring, isn't it? If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you really liked it, please subscribe to Shuttle Flash. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.